संकटस्यैवा विघ्नतस्येन जायते। शुक्लाम्बरधरं देवं शशिवरं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नं वदनं जायेत् सर्वविघ्नो प्रशान्ते। ओम श्री गणपति देवता की जय। श्री सरस्वती माता की जय। श्री गुरु देवता की जय। Let me take this opportunity to welcome each and every one of you to this the 17th session of this 21 nights of Gyan Yajna. We have listened to Bhagavad Katha, Ramayana Katha, Gita Katha, and we've listened to many presenters, and tonight we're very privileged to have with us a very, very learned individual who's no stranger to Sri Ram Mandir. Pandit Ashwaradath has been a member of this temple for many years, and now he's doing a wonderful job in Brampton, in the temple where he's the founder of the Bhavani Shankar Mandir. Tonight, I'm sure that he will bring to us message of the divine that will give us all something more to add to our entire paradigm of understanding of God, and hopefully to expand our paradigm of the understanding of God. So without further ado, I ask you to welcome our Vyas. Let's give him a wonderful round of applause, please. Pandit ji. Sure. There'll be one bhajan before we proceed. We're very pleased to see that Panditji has brought with him some of his sishyas, these young Brahmins who are here, and they're very, very impressively attired, and we are very proud of them, and we're very proud of what Pandit Haridath is doing, especially in that aspect of nurturing the young minds into such a Sanatana Dharma. Let's give our young Brahmins a wonderful round of applause, please.
प्रेम भाव से परे यनों के दोनों के हैं का Kirti pradeyatkhila manoradhade maharadhe Vidya pradayini saraswati nominityam Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara Gurur Sakshat Parabrahma Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Sarva Mangala Mangalye Shive Sarvartha Sadhike Sharanye Trambake Gauri Narayani Namostute Tat Purushaya Vidmahe Mahadevaya Dhimahi Tanno Rudrah Prachodayat. We clasp hands. Our thoughts, our meditation, all our energies are centered on the Lord of this Mandir, Bhagwan Shri Ram, Mata Sita, or Bhumi Putri, as we call her. Bhagwan Shri Ram, he is the energy, the form, and the deity that Bhagwan Shiva meditates upon. Mahashiv Puran tells us that when Parvati Mata asks Bhagwan Shiva, "Who do you meditate upon? You are Jagat Pita, the Lord of the universe. Who could you possibly pray to?" Bhagwan Shiva says, "Bhagwan Ram." Bhagwan Ram's innocence, his Maryada Purushottam, his willingness to always uphold the Dharma, the truth, his willingness to always uphold the values and morals of life has won the confidence of Bhagwan Shiva. Today, we close our eyes and we ask to be part of his blessings. Bhagwan Shri Ram, Maryada Purushottam, the Lord who has taken incarnation as a human form to experience the troubles of life and to demonstrate to us all that we are all going to face those troubles one day, whether we are Manushya, whether we are man, whether we are above the level of God's creation, whether we are the lowest level of God's creation, the animal kingdom, we are all one day going to experience pains. Swami Vivekananda tells us, pain makes the soul and the body strong. It prepares us for our challenges ahead. Bhagwan Shri Ram tells us, pain is inevitable. It will come to all of us. Some part of our life will be separated from something we love and cherish the most. And for him, it was his consort, Ma Sita Devi. Today we bow to that energy, that form, Bhagwan Shri Ram, the master of this temple, as we seek his blessings. Om Shri Ramaye Namaha. Everybody. Om Shri Ramaye Namaha. Om Shri Ramaye Namaha. Shri Rama Rama Raghunandan Rama Rama. Shri Rama Rama Bhartagraj Rama Rama. Shri Rama Rama Ranakarkash Rama Rama. Shri Rama Rama Sharanam Bhava Rama Rama. Shri Rama Chandra Charano Manasa Smarami. Shri Rama Chandra Charano Vachasa Granami. Shri Rama Chandra Charano Shirsha Namami. Shri Rama Chandra Charano Sharanam Prapadhe. Ramaya Rama Bhadraya Rama Chandraya Vedhase Raghunathaya Nathaya Sri
Sitaya Pataye Namah.
And to his consort, Mata Sita, who has taught us the messages of the earth. The earth, every day she is polluted. We take advantage on her. We build our homes and commit all sorts of acts upon her. Yet she teaches the message of tolerance. No matter what we do upon her, she tolerates our present, and she blesses us with fertility in the form of food. Today we pray to the earth and we ask to be recipients of her blessings. Mata Sita, Bhumi Putri, teach us the message of strength. Bless us with the ability to uphold the Dharma and to always stay by the ones we love the most. Om Janakatmajaya Vidmahe Sita Vallabhaya Dhimahi Tanno Sita Prachodayat. Janakatmajaya Vidmahe Bhumi Putri Chadhimahi Tanno Sita Prachodayat. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om. Prem se bolo Sri Ganapati Bhagavan ki jai. Sri Mahasaraswati Mata ki jai. Prem se bolo Guru Maharaj ki jai. Shiva Shankar Bhagavan ki jai. Bhavani Mata ki jai. Siyapati Ramachandra Bhagavan ki jai. Pahi pahi Gajanana Parvati Nandan Shubhanana. Pahi pahi Gajanana Parvati Nandan Shubhanana.
Pahi pahi Gajanana Parvati Nandan Shubhanana.
Pahi pahi Gajanana Parvati Nandan Shubhanana.
Pahi pahi Gajanana Parvati Nandan Shubhanana.
O Ekadanta Gajanana Anekadanta Vidyanana. Ekadanta Gajanana Anekadanta Vidyanana. Ekadanta Gajanana Anekadanta Vidyanana.
Ekadanta Gajanana Anekadanta Vidyanana.
Pahi pahi Gajanana Parvati Nandan Shubhanana.
Pahi pahi Gajanana Parvati Nandan Shubhanana.
Lambodar hai Gajanana, Lambodar hai 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 Shubhanana.
Sachi
विघ्नेश्वर
विघ्नेश्वर विघ्नेश्वर गजानना
विघ्नेश्वर विघ्नेश्वर
विघ्नेश्वर गजानना विघ्नेश्वर 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 गजानना विघ्नेश्वर 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 गजानना विघ्नेश्वर 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 गजानना
विघ्नेश्वर विघ्नेश्वर
विघ्नेश्वर गजानना विघ्नेश्वर गजानना
विघ्नेश्वर गजानना विघ्नेश्वर गजानना
विघ्नेश्वर 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 गजानना
विघ्नेश्वर 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 गजानना
विघ्नेश्वर गजानना
विघ्नेश्वर गजानना
विघ्नेश्वर गजानना विघ्नेश्वर है विघ्नेश्वर विघ्नेश्वर गजानना विघ्नेश्वर है विघ्नेश्वर विघ्नेश्वर गजानना
हे गणेश जी Help us to mold our intellect, to use our buddhi, to make positive choices. We bow to you, the supreme source of knowledge. Bole Ganapati Bhagavan ki jai. Respected Panditji, Pandit Rupnath Sharma ji, respected Pandits of Ram Mandir, Namaskar to all of you and to all my little students and to all of our congregation. My humble Namaskar and Pranam to all of you. It is a pleasure to be and satsang with you once again in this beautiful temple. I was here Saturday night and I mentioned, as I always do, when I come to Ram Mandir, I come to home, because I feel at home here and the respect and the honor that is displayed and given to me always here and my friends are always to the highest standard. And that's perhaps because I'm family to them. Many of you know, as Panditji mentioned, I was here at this temple. I served for 3 years as a Panditji, and I was very blessed to be associated with Pandit Rupnath Sharmaji and many of his Pandits who I learned a lot from. Today I'm able to apply some of that in my life and pass that back to our community in the form of teachings. It's a blessing to be here indeed, and thank you for having all of us, the members of Bhawani Shankar Mandir as well. They as well feel comfortable being here. My friends, today in our katha, this, as you know, is the celebration of Sri Ram Mandir's anniversary. And many of you, I'm sure, have been here when this beautiful temple was built. I remember coming to the first 21 night yagya that they had. And, you know, it was a very beautiful beginning. There was no carpet that you were sitting on. The altar was built, but not even fully completed. And I believe from that yagya, and for the blessings of Bhagwan Ram, over so many years, this mandir has blossomed and has, of course, demonstrated to be one of the leading temples, if not the one in the community, that has really gravitated people towards Dharma. We're very happy to be here, and it is always a pleasure to be in satsang in this beautiful temple. Tulsidas ji tells us, why are we here today?
Bina satsang vivek na hoi. राम कृपा बिनु सुलभन सोई सत्संगति मुद मंगल मूला सत संगति मुद मंगल मूला सोई फल सिद्धि सब साधन पूला सोई फल सिद्धि सब साधन पूला.
The second topic that is addressed in Ramayana, the first being the Guru. The second topic addressed in Sri Ramcharitmanas, this beautiful book of Tulsidas Ji and Valmiki, is satsang. Satsang, bina satsang viveka na hoi, this is nothing new to any of you here, especially in Ram Mandir, you're a very educated audience. Binu satsang viveka na hoi, without satsang, vivek na hoi, knowledge is impossible, very difficult to attain. Rama kripa bina sulabhana soi, and even the compassion of Prabhu Ram is, my friends, sulab, difficult to attain. Why is Tulsidas Ji making this the second topic of Ramayana? And why is it so difficult for man to not ascend without satsang? One day, Guru Vaishvamitra was demonstrating this discussion to Bhagwan Ram, and he uses a beautiful example. He says, Bhagwan Ram, this is Valmiki Ramayana. He says, Ram, my child, that in this world, people will be like bubbles. Or people will be like, you know, animals in an ocean. Animals in an ocean. And a boat will come to save everyone. A boat will come to save everyone. That boat is called the satsang. And everyone in the ocean are us, just living our lives together. Bhagwan Ram says, why is that boat so important? He said, satsang is the boat that keeps us together. There was a time when it was difficult. Back, those of you who lived in Guyana and back in the West Indies, it was difficult to get electricity every day or every night. What would happen when there was no electricity? We would light a little kerosene lamp or something of that nature, and we'll place it in the home or in the yard. And when that happens, everybody will gravitate to that one light. That into that one light, they will sit together, they will eat, they will talk of their day's work. Sometimes they say bad things happen for good reason. They will sit and they will talk about life, about their day's work. And as soon as electricity comes back, everybody goes back to their respective rooms. When we're together, what happens? We're forced to talk. When you're here together today, we're forced to pray. You're first forced to contain your thoughts in this temple. That is the power of satsang. You're forced to not think outside. No matter how much of a hard day you've had, you're forced to contain all your thoughts and emotions here. And if you spend another hour here, you know for certain that your thoughts and emotions will be contained and you'll be helped. Tulsidas Ji says that this is the magic of satsang. It brings us together. We are forced to think together. No matter what I say here today, you will have to listen. If we were outside there talking in the street, you'd be telling me things and I'd be telling you things and we wouldn't get the gist of our discussion. But today you get to listen like all the other days. You get to be a part of satsang and you get to elevate, my friends. Satsangatve nisangatvam, nisangatve nirmohatvam, nirmohatve nischalitattvam, nischalitattve jivan mukti. This is from the Bhaja Govindam by Adi Shankaracharya.
Bhaja Govindam, भज गोविंदम गोविंदम भज मूद मते भज गोविंदम भज गोविंदम गोविंदम भज मूद मते सत्संगत्वे निसंगत्वम निसंगत्वे निर्मोहत्वं निर्मोहत्वे निश्चलितत्वं निश्चलितत्वे जीवनमूर्ति भज गोविंदम भज गोविंदम गोविंदम भज मूदमते भज गोविंदम गोविंदम भज मूदमते भज गोविंदम भज गोविंदम गोविंदम भज मूदमते
सत्संगत्वे निर्मोहत्वं निर्मोहत्वे निश्चलितत्वं निश्चलितत्वे जीवन्मुक्ति. The first and the last words of that shloka gives you the meaning. Satsangatve jivan mukti. Our goal in life is to be free. That is to have mukti, to be free from the shackles of life, from anger, from lust, greed, and all that. What helps us to do that? Satsangasve jivan mukti. Every day, my friends, we are dying to die in order to attain emancipation. We feel as though emancipation or freedom will come after death, marne ki baad. Lekin jivan mein kya hota hai? What will happen when we are living? We have to be free as well. We have to be free while we are living. Satsang helps us to free ourselves while we are alive. And for that reason, we all are here today. And we'll continue to be until this yagya is over. And continue to be whenever these wonderful satsangs are held. Whenever it is held, go, be part of it. Because most of the times we are not part of satsang and our mind is astray. We are the Arjunas of the world. And the Lord Bhagwan Shri Krishna needs to hold us down. When you come to satsang, and this is more on the humor side, and you're permitted to laugh, of course. Some of you are very tense. I don't know if you had a bad day at work, but you need to smile up. Pandit Sharma always talks about smiling in the temple. So you need to loosen up, and you need to have some humor. It is said that when you come to satsang, there are three types of people that comes to satsang. Three types of people, three types of audience. So imagine how many of you are here, three types you're divided into. The first type is called the Shruta. Shruta. Shruta comes from Shravan, which means to listen. So these people, they come honestly, they come to listen, they come to digest, they come to learn, and they will pay attention when the Vyasji is reading. Those are called Shruta. First one is called what? I'm going to mark your test paper here, you know. Second kind of people that come to satsang is called Sarota. Saruta. They come because they come to satsang, but they want to have a mini satsang. You know what that is, right? So you have a satsang, but there's a little mini discussion happening in the back. You know how day was hard and how things were, train was late and so on and so forth, and rain was falling and so on. Mandir looks beautiful. And they listen a little bit what the Pandaji had to say. So what are they called? Saruta. Second type of people. They're not so bad. The third kind of people that come to satsang is called Sota. What you think they come to do? Come to sleep. When Pandaji is talking, they will take a nap. And when Pandaji says, "Are bhai dandhari, is not that truth?" He says, "Yes, Pandaji, it is truth." Right, Bhai Paul? You're awake though. So three types of people. Shrota. The next one is Sarota. And the last one is Sota. Luckily, we only have the first type here today in this beautiful satsang. All of you are alert and now you're laughing and you're smiling. So we are prepared to start our satsang. Today, we will discuss brief discussion because I believe these brief discussions are meaningful, especially in this, you know, these 21 nights of yagya. We will talk today about focus on your dharma. We have been sent here, Bhagwan Shri Krishna tells Arjuna in the Bhagavad Gita. And in the Mahabharata as well, very beautiful series going on in television right now about the importance of our presence in this world. Why are you here? Why did God send you? Why did God send you with the things that you have? Why did God give you a house? Why did God give you intellect? Why did God give you buddhi? Why did God give you everything that you have? There is a reason, and today we will talk about that. It is said, we are here to preserve dharma. We are here to preserve dharma. I am sure all of you, without exception, have heard of this word dharma before. Dharma means many things to different people. To some people, dharma means religion. Far from that, by the way. To some of us, dharma means a way of life. To some of us, dharma means an activity. To some of us, dharma means a thought or a character. Whatever dharma means to you, I want you to hold on to that. And let's have a discussion today and understand this purpose of us being here and what we are here to uphold in this world. So it is said, Hindus consider dharma the very foundation of life. You can follow the writing. It means that which holds. Dharma come from the word dhri, the root word dhri, which means that which to hold. The people of this world and the entire creation. If we should answer partly what dharma means, it means that which holds together. it is like the hub of a wheel with different spokes. The hub of that wheel is called the dharma that holds all of creation together. Dharma is the moral law combined with spiritual discipline that guides one's life. So moral law and spiritual discipline. What is the moral law? We'll talk some of that today. And the spiritual discipline. We can have so many laws in our life. Many, many laws. Laws of the country and moral laws. But there has to be a spiritual discipline behind it to execute that moral law, to uphold dharma. We will talk about that today. Hinduism describes dharma as the natural universal laws whose observance enables humans to be contented and happy and to save himself from degradation and suffering. There are rules put in place for us to follow. And when we follow that, it prevents us from degrading ourselves and suffer. That is part of dharma as well. Dharma is described as that. Dharma is also described as the law of being, without which things cannot exist. So think about not physically, but spiritual behaviors, in which if we do not display, we will cease to exist. We'll talk of some of those today as well. That is considered the practice of dharma. According to the scriptures, Ramayana, I think all of you know this. Ki daya dharma ka mool hai, paap mool abhiman. Daya dharma ka mool hai, aur paap mool abhiman. Tulsi daya na choriye, jab tak tan me pran. I feel happy when you chant as well. Daya dharma ka mool hai, paap mool abhiman. Tulsi daya na choriye, jab tak tan me pran. The root of dharma is compassion. You can read it there for yourself. Daya dharma ka mool hai. The root of dharma is compassion. Pride is the root of evil. As long as life is present, do not give up compassion. Why is it that dharma, that the root of dharma is called compassion? Daya dharma ka mool hai. Mool, the root. And that is one of the reasons, children will know and adults as well, why we touch someone's feet. We can compare that to the plant. If you have a beautiful plant, you will put all the nutrients in the root. All the nice things, the mold you'll put in the root, the manure and everything you'll put at the root. You want it to send that energy, to send that food to the different parts of the plant. The plant, therefore, gives beautiful fruits, and we are blessed with those fruits in life. Daya dharma ka mool hai. When we touch someone's feet, that is why we touch their feet. We wanted to walk the path they have walked. We want to embrace the values that they have embraced. That's why you touch the feet. Walk the path that they have walked. Embrace the values that they have embraced. We want to tread the path that they have tread. Are you thinking back now whose feet you have touched in life? Whose and whose feet you have touched in life? You want to tread the path that they have tread in life. That, my friends, is the root. Daya dharma ka mool hai. When the root is filled with compassion, everything else blossoms in love. When inside of all of us, dharma is inside of all of us. We'll talk about that today. Tulsidas ji, however, starts us off with daya dharma ka mool hai, the root of dharma. To attain any dharma, to practice any dharma, whether your dharma is compassion or non-violence, there must be compassion in your life. And so he tells us, Tuti Dayana Choriye, as long as life is present, do not give up compassion. And so this principle was taken up by Buddha as well. He talked about dharma in Dhammapad. The Atharva Veda described dharma symbolically as Prithavim Dharmana Dhritam. That is, the world is upheld by dharma. Let us go through now and establish this dharma. There are 10 principles of dharma. Dhriti kshama damosteyam manusmriti saucham indriya nigraha dhirvidya satyama krodha dasham dharma lakshanam. This is some of the lessons we teach in Balvihar classes. The 10 principles of dharma. What are the 10 principles of dharma? This is your dharma, by the way. If you intend to practice dharma, this is what you practice. This is what you uphold in life. And so Manusmriti tells us, the first of all is Satya. Satya is a dharma. Hinduism is considered a religion. Hinduism is considered many things, a way of life, a set of practices that can shape us towards better human beings. But dharma is beyond that. Our dharma is called Sanatan Dharma, eternal, not founded by anyone. And what is the first principle of that dharma? The first principle of that dharma is Satya. Satya. There is no way you can tell me you do not understand what Satya is in life.
Satya barabar tap nahi, jhoot barabar paap, jaake hridaya satya hai, vaake hridaya aap.
Very old verse.
Satya barabar tap nahi, jhoot barabar paap, jaake hridaya satya hai, vaake hridaya aap.
Satya barabar tap nahi. You have done penances in your life. You have done prayers. You have done oblations. You have done offerings.
Satya barabar tap nahi.
There is no prayer. There is no prayer greater than speaking the truth. No prayer greater than speaking the truth. Why is that so? Why is that so? There is no prayer greater than truth. This very ancient verse tells us. What is the purpose of praying when life is asatya? What is the purpose of being a bhakta, having bhakti, when there is no satya? A bhakta, a devotee, without satya is fake. Satya barabar tap nahi. No matter how much milk you pour on the lingam, no matter how much devotion you give, but a person whose life is absent of satya, that person's devotion is incomplete. That person's dharma is incomplete. That person appears to God on an external look, but internally, there's an absence of the root, which is satya. Satya barabar tap nahi. No prayer, I can emphasize again, is greater than speaking the truth. Ramayana tells us,
Ram Siya Ram Siya Ram Jai Ram Ram Shri Ram Jai Ram Shri Ram Satya Mool Sab Sukrit Suhava Satya mool sab sukrit suhava Agamanigam puran bakhanam Agamanigam puran bakhanam Bolo Ram Shri Ram Jai Ram Shri Ram Ram Shri Ram Jai Ram, Shri Ram Prem Bhagati Jal Binu Anurai Prem Bhagati Jan Binu Anurai Abhiyantar Man Kabahu Na Jai Abhiyantar Mal Kabahu Na Jai Bolo Ram, Shri Ram Jai Ram, Shri Ram, Ram, Jai Ram,
Jai Ram, Shri Ram.
O jahi vidhi Prabhu prasan man koi, jahi vidhi Prabhu prasan man koi. करुणा सागर की जय सोई करुणा सागर की जय सोई राम श्री राम जय राम श्री राम राम श्री राम जय राम श्री Satya mool sab sukriti suhava.
Bhagwan Ram, these are his words in the Ramayana, my friends. We must acknowledge them and embrace them. Satya mool sab sukriti suhava. The first principle, satya. The Lord says, Satya mool sab sukriti suhava. Truth, he says, it's the root of all noble virtues. Truth is the root of all noble virtues. If at all we want to display all the noble virtues in life or have them, then internally in the core, there has to be truthfulness. Truthfulness, he says, Veda Purana Vinita Managai, the Vedas and the Puranas, the Smritis, all of them support this fact that truth is the root of all noble virtues. Why is it that we are gravitating to the non-truth in most aspects?
Krodh na chhora, jhoot na chhora, satya vachan kyu chhor diya tujhe, naam japan kyu chhor diya. Krodh na chhora, jhoot na chhora, सत्य वचन क्यों छोड़ दिया नाम जपन क्यों छोड़ दिया नाम जपन क्यों छोड़ दिया
क्रोध न छोड़ा झूठ न छोड़ा we have never the poet is saying this doesn't apply to all of you here of course as a general statement of life क्रोध न छोड़ा we have failed to throw away anger. Jhoot na chora. We have failed to throw away the truth. We have all kept that anger and untruth. Satya vachan kyu chor diya? Why are we leaving satya vachan and running away when it is the root of all noble virtues? The author tells us today, Bhaktas of Bhagwan Ram, Bhagwan Krishna, the Lord is telling us, hold on to the truth. Hold on to the truth. We as Hindus, we are blessed to worship the truth.
Satyam Shivam Sundaram Satyam Shivam Sundaram O Satyam Shivam Sundaram Satyam Shivam Sundaram Satyam Shivam Sundaram Satyam Shivam Sundaram सत्यम शिवम सुंदर ईश्वर सत्य है सत्य ही शिव है शिव ही सुंदर है सत्यम शिवम सुंदरम सत्यम शिवम सुंदरम सत्यम शिवम सुंदरम
Bhagavan Shiva is referred to in Mahashi Puran, Satyam Shivam Sundaram. He is the form of Satya, Shiva and Sundaram. Form of truth, the form of auspiciousness and the form of beauty. We, as Hindus, we are very unique. We worship everything. We worship the skies, the earth, the plants, the trees, the animals, the space, the water. We even worship the truth. We worship the truth. That is why we do Satya Narayan Bhagavan Puja. Ekada Naimisharanya Rishya Saunakadaya. We worship the truth, especially in Purnima when we do full moon katha, as you know it. Why do we worship the moon when it is full? Or perform Satya Narayan katha, especially when it is full? The full moon represents the truth. The truth is always whole. It is never absent of anything. I've said this many times in the temple. You'll never hear somebody saying, I swear to tell you half of the truth, the whole half of the truth and nothing but half of the truth. They say, I swear to tell the truth, the whole truth and nothing but the truth. Truth is whole. Purna represents the moon. Purnamada, Purnamidam, Purnat, Purnamudachyate, Purnasya Purnamadaya, Purnameva Vashishyate. You take the full remains the full. This is a verse Pandaji quoted here Saturday night. That is truth. You take truth from the truth does not get lessened. It remains as the truth. Young children, grown adults, all of us. Truth is not only for young people, it is for everybody. Everybody, speak the truth. And not only speak the truth about other people, we have to live a truthful life and reflect truth about ourselves. Some people will say, unfortunately, I'm the speaker of the truth and I will tell you the truth when it is time to tell you the truth. Unfortunately, many times we do not reveal the truth about ourselves. We need to accept who we are. We need to deal with who we are. We need to make changes, reveal the truth to ourselves. How many of us honestly How many of us honestly think we carry a few extra pongs? If you do. Honestly. I do. No, you don't have to put up your hand. Every day I tell myself that I'm truthful to myself that I carry a few extra pongs. And what do I have? Having known that truth, we have to reveal that truth to ourselves and take action to change. Do not say, the pants is getting tight. The pants is not getting tight. We are getting bigger. The kurta is not getting tight. Kurtas are very loose and it should be worn like that. It's us. We are growing. But we cannot accept that truth when the spouse gets a little few pongs. We say that, you know, you are getting a few pongs. But we are not seeing ourselves. That is the truth. That is the truth of life. It may appear to be funny to many of you, but it is the truth. My friends, reveal the truth. Satya barabar tapanahi, no prayer. No prayer in this world. You remember the katha of Satyadev in Devi Bhagwat? Satyadev, he could not tell a single lie in his life. Not a single lie he could have told. His name was Satyavrata, they changed his name to Satyadev. He went into the forest, he was practicing tapasya, and an injured boar came in his way, shot by a king. Satyavrata saw the injured boar with an arrow inside of him. Compassion he felt for the boar. The boar went to his right hand side. The king came and said, Satyavrata, where did the boar go? He cannot tell a lie. He asked himself, he says, if I tell the truth that this boar went this way, this king is going to kill him. If I tell him the boar went the other way, I'll be telling a lie. What should I do? The king says, Satyavrata, you're a man of your word. Tell me, where did this boar go? Satyavrata says, well, my eyes saw where it went. The king says, well, tell me. He says, my mouth can speak, but my mouth didn't see where it go. My eyes see where it went. My mouth didn't see where it went, and my mouth cannot speak where it went. He found so many ways to keep his dharma. Dharmaraj Yudhishthira, when he was fighting the battle of Mahabharata, he was such a righteous person, always told the truth. His chariot was above the ground. His chariot was above the ground when he was fighting. Did not mix with the army. Satya is what defines us. And that is why it is the first principle of our dharma. Whatever prayers you do, understand, it must be truthful. Whoever we are, we must be truthful about ourselves and reveal that truth. And so, Satya barabar tapanahi, Satya prema karuna, these are the fundamental teachings of our dharma. The second principle of this 10th principles of Hindu dharma is called Ahimsa. I'm sure all of you know what Ahimsa is. Bhagavad Gita tells us, chapter 16, verse 2, what Ahimsa is. Bhagavad Gita. Ki ahimsa satyama krodha styaga shantir paishunam daya bhuteshvalo luptam mardhavam hriracha palam. Ahimsa satyama krodha styaga shantir paishunam. What are the conduct of a person of dharma? A person who follows dharma, what are the conduct of that person, the qualities of that person? We're all here to preserve that. What is that quality? The first and foremost is ahimsa. Ahimsa means non-injury, non-violence. Non-injury is not necessarily physically hurting someone. You know, they say, what damage the tongue can do to a person's life, the physical hard bones of a body cannot do. When you open your mouth to speak to someone, my friends, you must understand the words that you're speaking are like toothpaste. It can never go in back the tube. Careful of what you tell people. Say things not to necessarily make people happy. Say things not to necessarily compliment people when they're not deserving of receiving that. But say things to elevate people. Non-injury is not necessarily physically harming somebody. It is what you say as well. It comes deep down inside of us. Compassion is the one that really reveals all of that. Non-injury. Do not harm any creatures in this life. If I may read for you word from the Gita. All lives at all levels are manifestations of the cosmic life. all life, animal life, insect life, people's life. They're all manifestations of that one cosmic life upstairs from the divine Lord. Recognizing sacredness in every life, recognizing sacredness in all of them, and not choosing to hurt them, for sport is non-injury, or what we call ahimsa. We cannot just hurt. There's a difference between defensing and hurting. There's a big difference between that. But do not hurt just because you feel glad doing it. I want to give you a little experience, because I like to give these things practical experience as well. This year in March, I was in Vrindavan, Vrajdham, or the Dham, the place of love and purity. And so that beautiful place, my second visit there, had nothing to do, but I just had to go. One of the things, I think few of you have gone to Vrajdham, where you take a rickshaw and you go to Lohi Bazaar to do your little wandering about and pray and so on. The rickshaws there are so many of them. And they're going, and they're like, you know, have you ever watched many ants all crossing a line together? They meet each other, but they're gone, they're way afterwards. So many rickshaws and bicycle, and you sit on one of them and you're riding, and they're touching all sort of things and people and so on. And there in Vraj, they ride and they'll hit somebody with the bike and they'll go, Radhe Radhe. And the other person will go, Radhe Radhe. And everything, please is Radhe Radhe, thank you is Radhe Radhe, sorry is Radhe Radhe. Everything in Vraj is Radhe Radhe. And I'm amazed to see these guys are riding their bicycle and they would touch somebody and the person will look back and say, Radhe Radhe. It's like, why did you touch me? And the rickshaw wala will go, Radhe Radhe. Like, I'm sorry. And then the guy who has got hurt will go, Radhe Radhe, I forgive you. When it's a place of so much love, so that even if they hit you intentionally or not, they do not display any anger. They do not hurt you. They do not tell you anything that will hurt you. In different parts of the world, if you look people a little funny, they tell you off. They tell you, why are you looking at me like that? I didn't like the way you looked at me. That is what the world is becoming. And Vraj is such a beautiful experience. Everybody hitting everybody, falling down, and they're saying Radhe Radhe. And so this is called non-injury. Do not hurt, especially with words. And so ahimsa satyama krodha, Shri Krishna Bhagwan tells Arjuna in the Bhagavad Gita, ahimsa satyama krodha shantira rapayishunam. Let there be peace. Peace does not necessarily have to be in one particular place. Internally is where peace belongs. And so when it is there, everything else is cultivated in a loving manner. So ahimsa, the second principle of dharma. Third, brahmacharya, the stage where we are dedicated to learning alone. Brahmacharya in Hindu principles of practices, is where we dedicate our life towards learning, studying. You know, they say it's the tree, a mango tree. As it blossoms and it bears the fruit, all the nutrients it takes from the root, as I told you this, and it gives towards the fruit. And when the mango tree, not when the fruit feels, when the mango tree feels it is time to let go of the fruit, it lets go of the fruit. When it feels like the fruit is ripened, or the fruit is yellow, some of you say, is ready to eat, the tree feels that it is time for me to let go of that fruit. And so it lets go of the fruit, falls in the ground, and that, it is said, that is the sweetest mango, when it is ripe on the tree, not when it is force-ripe. Children, we have to learn that principle from our parents. Our parents take you from birth, they cuddled you, they nurtured you, they have you, they've given you all their values. And when they feel you're ripened enough, when they feel that you're responsible enough, when they feel it is time for you to go, and they do know when that is, they let you go independently, because they know now you can offer those principles like the mango, those sweetness to the world. That is called brahmacharya, being under the guidance of your guru or your parents, and focus your attention 100% on learning. That is called brahmacharya. And so the Hindu principles and or the Hindu dharma is so uniquely designed to help us focus so that we build our future on the Brahmacharya stage. The fourth principle of Dharma is called Asteya, or no desire to possess or steal. What is mine, I will work for it. What is somebody else's, they have worked for it. I have no desire to possess what they have or to steal what they have. Whatever I want, I will work for it. Asteya. Number five, Aparigraha, non-corrupt. Stay pure, stay clean, but do not be corrupted. These are the principles of our Dharma. And the sixth principle, Shaucha, means cleanliness. Cleanliness of course, mind, body, senses, thoughts. All of that has to be cleansed. But importantly as well, our environment, how we present ourselves, our clothes. Everything represents or reflects discipline. The clothes that we wear, the place that we sit, the car that we drive, the place that we dwell, the place that we work, it represents our Dharma. Being a Hindu or being a Dharmic Hindu is just not about prayers. Being a Hindu is about caring for your environment and yourself. It's about reflection. Whatever you are, whatever you're wearing today reflects your thought. It reflects your Dharma. And so we're taught so many things, to take bath. The students are told to take bath, to keep a positive outlook and a clean outlook, and internally as well, to be cleansed. So our sixth principle of Dharma is cleanliness. Then, Santosha. Everybody repeat after me. Santosha. Santosham. Param. Sukham. Santosham. Param. Sukham. One more time. Santosham. Param Sukham. And that means contentment is the highest form of happiness. Contentment, different from complacent. Contentment, your ability to be content. Bhagwan is telling us, have this principle to be content. It does not mean that you're going to have a little job and be content with that. You know, that's complacency. This is what I want in my life. I want nothing else. That is not contentment. Contentment is acceptance of who you are, accepting the principles that God has blessed you with, and working towards higher principle. Contentment means absence of jealousy, not wanting what your friend have necessarily, but wanting to uplift yourself because you want to. You want to become better. Contentment, santosham, the highest form of happiness. Swadhyaya, reading of the scriptures. In our community, we have introduced Bhagavad Gita. This book is no stranger to any Hindu. And if it is, you should get one and keep it in your house, not wrapped in a red or a yellow or a white cloth or a silk cloth. That is done after you read it. Open it and read it. The Gita and the Ramayana are no stranger to any one of us. Reading of the scriptures, this is Rishi Yajna. This is how we honor the hard work of our saints. Night and day they studied and they penned all their ideas together and the facts of Dharma for us to read. The eighth principle of Dharma tells us, Swadhyaya, read the scriptures daily. Let it be one line, let it be a verse, but honor the saints and elevate yourself. Nine, tapas, or austerity, perseverance, and penance. Tapasya, the word means to melt. I always give the kids this example. As you take scrap iron, and you melt it to have a finished product. Tapasya is melting of the self. Melting of the self, analyzing yourself, self-introspection. Go through and says, yes, this is not what I want to be. This is not who I am. I am better than this. Melt yourself down through tapasya, through prayers, through penance, through austerity. If you check the Hindu calendar, about half of the year is all parbs and religious functions, Purnima, Ekadashi, Trayodashi, and all these kind of things. If you fast all of those days, half of the year you're doing penance. Through tapasya, we are melted to become someone different in a positive way. And lastly, Ishvara Pranidhanam, regular prayers. And that is just like you eat breakfast, we must pray. Some of us say, Panaji, I pray in my heart, so I don't need to come to the temple. Panaji, I pray in my mind. My friends, we are not that powerful. We have not gotten to that stage as yet where we are able single-handedly to pray in our mind and pray in our heart. That is why you have places like this, where you can come and have educated people sit here as it always is, and help us to contain our thoughts. Help us to form our mind up. We can't always pray in our mind and in our heart. It doesn't work. Doesn't work. We have to come and pray regularly. Sit at your altar. I always have a saying in the temple, your altar alters your life. Your altar alters your life. You sit there and you pour all your problems out. You pour all your happy moments out as well to God. Communicate with the Lord. And so what happens? We feel as though we are in therapy. That is what many of our people do. They pay thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars to go to a shrink, all to tell the shrink their problem. The shrink writes it on a piece of paper, and after the ceremony, summarizes everything and said, this is your problem. Isn't that interesting? You tell them all your problem, he summarizes and said, this is your problem. Go and fix it. We have to communicate our problems to God. Unburdening, taking off the bundle, is telling God our troubles and communicating your happy moments. That is what prayers are. All of us undoubtedly must continue that. As we're wrapping up the session, we will look into the Gita, practice of Dharma brings perfection. Sve sve karna karmanya bhirataḥ sam siddhim labate narah swakarma nirata siddhim yata vindati tachrinuh. Devoted to his own duty, devoted to his own duty, man attains the highest perfection. How engaged is his own duty? He attains perfection that you do here. First line is very important. Sve sve karmanya abhirataha. Devoted to your duty, not to somebody else's. In life, it is human tendency for us to look at a person's life and comment on the path that they are walking on. Comment on the activities that they are doing. Commenting on the thoughts that they have in mind. But we have to focus on our duty. When we focus on others and other issues in life, we lose focus on where we're going. None of you will ever see a man driving on the road and he's looking at the side like this. Or he's looking on top like this, unless it's for a quick glance to see what the color of the sky is. Never do that. They always have to focus on the bigger screen. The rear view mirror is always small like this. That's for a quick glance in order to move forward. Focus on your dharma in order to move forward. We attain the highest perfection, Bhagwan Shri Krishna says when we do that. Next verse. Yatha pravrittir bhutanam yena sarvam idam tatham swakarmanatam abhyarchya siddhim vindati manavah yatha pravrittir bhutanam. By worship of the Lord, who is the source of all beings and who is all-pervading, man can, in the performance of his own duty, attain perfection. Worship, there's tremendous merit in it. God gives us strength through our worship. And God is the source of all beings. Yes, there is help out there from friends and relatives, but God is the source of all beings. He understands our troubles. We always say Hanumanji holds the mountain in his hands, not necessarily to save Lakshmana's life alone, but to tell us that he can fetch the problems, the mountainous problems that you have. He has the aushadhi, the medicine for all our cures. Bhagwanji has, through prayers. He's all-pervading. He can perform miracles in our life when we pray to him. And so, the question is asked now. We know what is dharma. Dharma are practices, they are principles that can hold us together. Satya, prem, karuna, compassion, truth, cleanliness, abstinence of injury. We know that is your dharma. You will start practicing them or continue to practice them. Now the question is asked by Arjuna in the Gita, whose dharma is better? My dharma of truth is better than your dharma of compassion. My dharma of non-injury is better than your dharma of cleanliness. Whose dharma is better? Sometimes they are the eight, we don't have time tonight to discuss that, but the eight kinds of egos. Ahankar, power, bal ahankar, when you're strong, you say, I am stronger than him, so I'm better. And so these things, affiliation to them, sometimes take away the purpose of life. The question is asked, very popular verse in the Gita. Shriyan swadharmo vigunah paradharmat swanushtitat swabhava nityam karma kurvam napnoti kilvisham. Please chant with me. Shriyan
स्वधर्मो
स्वधर्मो
विगुणः
विगुणः
पराधर्मात्
पराधर्मात्
स्वनुष्ठितात् स्वभवा नियतं कर्म कुर्वं नाप्नोति किल्बिषम्.
Whose dharma is better? Is a man of truthfulness better than the man who's practicing compassion? Because you practice cleanliness, are you better than the person practicing bhakti, devotion? Who is better, or whose dharma is better? Bhagwan Sri Krishna answers this confusing question from Arjuna. Oh Arjuna, he says, better is one's own dharma, though imperfect, than the dharma of another well performed. Better is one's own dharma, though imperfect, than the dharma of another well performed. This, to some level, in Guyana especially, we try to speak about this verse a lot and relate it to religion, where conversion is very rapid in that country and many others. And so many times people are asked to convert from one religion to the next. I don't think it's that rapid in Canada here, because we have very good relations with other religions as well. We are able to speak to them and communicate. But better is your own dharma, though imperfect, than that of another. Remember, we are all practicing different values of life. If your life is to be truthful and truthful in all aspects, it does not mean that a man of compassion does not speak truthfulness. Their dharma is to follow compassion. It does not mean that yours is better than theirs. Don't take your focus off of yours and put it on theirs. It means that less focus you are putting on being truthful. Same thing with developing ourselves. Do not focus on others' development. Focus on developing yourself and helping others. Better is your own dharma, though imperfect. It may not be perfect. It may not be perfect, but whatever percentage of practice you give to it, it is better than that of another well performed. And so, in summary tonight, what we have learned, my friends, I want us to look at these words very carefully about our dharma. The purpose of dharma is not only to attain a union of the soul with the supreme reality. It also suggests a code of conduct that is intended to secure both worldly joys and supreme bliss. It's a power that enables us to attain, in other words. Anything that helps human being to reach God is dharma. Whether it is Hinduism or truth or compassion or cleanliness, it is dharma. And anything that hinders human being from reaching God is adharma. Yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata abhyutanam adharmasya tadatmanam sujamyaham. That is the philosophy of Gita, why the Lord came to erase adharma and to establish dharma. Whatever is impeding you from reaching God, that is called adharma. You know what that is? Simple things, anger, lust, greed, jealousy, the real enemies that we ask the Lord to kill. That is adharma when it is practiced. And your karma, very importantly, your karma is your dharma. Remember, we have to practice what we believe and what we preach. My question to you tonight before we complete is, what is your dharma? And will you focus on your dharma? So take 30 seconds before we complete and focus on what is your dharma right now. Let me ask you, let me help you. Is your dharma to tell the truth or to live a truthful life? Is your dharma to be compassionate to all animals, all form of life? Is your dharma to be helpful? Is your dharma to uplift others? Is your dharma nonviolence? And if any of those are your dharma, or a combined of all of them, reflect right now, what is your dharma? If it is combined of everything, then are you going to focus on your dharma and leave the focus away from others? This is my humble message to you tonight. I hope you leave with a message. And that message is that you are here to practice your dharma and to uplift yourself and others in the process. As we conclude, I'd like to sing a short, beautiful song and ask Bhagwan Shri Krishna's blessings on all of you to help you to uphold your dharma. Bole Shri Krishna Chandra Bhagavan ki jai.
श्री राधे 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 बरसाने वाले राधे, श्री राधे 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 बरसाने वाले राधे, श्री राधे 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 बरसाने वाले राधे,
श्री राधे 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 बरसाने वाले राधे,
ओ श्री राधे 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 बरसाने वाली राधे,
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 ओ वृंदावन के कण कण बोले श्री राधा राधा,
श्री राधा राधा,
ओ श्री राधा राधा, श्री राधा राधा, श्री यमुना जी की लहरे बोले श्री राधा राधा,
श्री राधा राधा,
श्री राधा राधा,
श्री राधा राधा,
ओ श्री राधा राधा, श्री राधा राधा,
श्री राधा राधा, श्री राधा राधा,
श्री राधे 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 बरसाने वाले राधे,
श्री राधे 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 बरसाने वाले राधे,
ओ श्याम सुंदर की बंसी बोले श्री राधा राधा,
श्री राधा राधा,
ओ भक्त जनों की मन से गूंजे श्री राधा राधा,
श्री राधा राधा,
ओ श्री राधा राधा, श्री राधा राधा,
श्री राधा राधा, श्री राधा राधा,
श्री राधे 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 बरसाने वाले राधे,
श्री राधे 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 बरसाने वाले राधे,
ओ रसिक जनों की वाणी बोले श्री राधा राधा,
श्री राधा राधा,
ओ ब्रज की लता पता भी बोले श्री राधा राधा,
श्री राधा राधा,
ओ ब्रज मन हे भज मन श्री राधे गोपाल, भज मन श्री राधे गोपाल, श्री राधे 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 बरसाने वाले राधे,
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 श्री राधे 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 बरसाने वाली 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 राधे,
बोले श्री राधा कृष्ण भगवान। जल्दी करो, वो चांदी मेधा सुक्तम तो माँ सरस्वती देवी, वन ऑफ द ब्यूटिफुल वेदिक चैंटिंग। ओम यस चंदसाम वृषभो विश्वरूपः समिंद्रो मे दया स्मृणोतु श्रुतं मे गोपाय
ओम शांति 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 ओम मेधा देवी जुषमाना
नागादिश्वाची भद्रासु मनस्यमाना त्वया जुष्टानु जमाना दुरुक्तारां ग्रहत्वदे विर्दे सुवीराः त्वया जुष्टानिशे भवधीरि त्वया ब्रह्मागतक्षीरुदत्वया त्वया जुष्टश्चित्रं विन्ददेवस्थानो
मेधां देवी सरस्वती
मेधामे अश्विना भुवावा दत्तां पुष्करसृजा अप्सरासूचया मेधा गन्धर्वेषु जयन्मना देवी मेधा सरस्वती सामा मेधा सुरभिर्विश्वा स्वाहा
आमा मेधा सुरभिर्विश्वरूपा हिरण्यवर्णां जगतीतगन्या ऊर्जस्वती पयसा पिन्वमाना आमा मेधा सुप्रतीका जुषन्ताम् मयि मेधा मयि प्रजा मयि
अग्निस्तेजो ददातु मयि मेधा मयि प्रजा मयि इन्द्र इन्द्रियं ददातु
मयि मेधा मयि प्रजा मयि सूर्यो ब्राजो ददातु ॐ महादिव्यै च विद्महे
विष्णुपत्न्यै च धीमहि तन्नो वाणी प्रचोदयात्
ॐ हंस हंसाय विद्महे परमहंसाय धीमहि तन्नो हंस प्रचोदयात् ओम शांति
शांति शांति
प्रेम से बोलो सरस्वती माता की जय
प्रेम सूर्य व्यास महाराज की
जय
सच्चे सनातन धर्म